Are you operating WooCommerce online store and you would like to offer shipping methods from different carriers, but you don't want to invest a fortune into buying separate plugin for each of the carriers? Well, we've got a solution just for you. Hey, it's Dmitry from One Team Software, and today we're going to look at our new EasyPost Shipping plugin for WooCommerce. So typically you have to buy a plugin for each of the carriers you want to ship with. For example, you want to ship with FedEx, you buy a plugin for FedEx. You want to ship with USPS, you buy a plugin for USPS. It quickly adds up as you start adding more and more carriers in order to satisfy your customers, and then it becomes so expensive that you will think like, why do I have to pay so much? Well, not anymore. Let me introduce you service which is called EasyPost. It's a unique aggregator which offers shipping with more than 100 carriers worldwide. So what it means that with only one plugin from One Team Software, you will be able to handle them all with only one small annual fee. Without further ado, let's jump right into this lengthy tutorial, which I think takes over 30 minutes. So be strong and see how it works. All right, in order to install the plugin, first of all, we will go to One Team Software website where you can search for it just by typing EasyPost and opening the page, or going to extensions and it will be listed somewhere in the grid. So we'll open it. Then we'll quickly add it to the cart, view cart. Proceed to checkout. Then you will fill your information over here. We suggest you to subscribe to our newsletter in order not to miss any updates, deals, and so on. We don't spam, so you won't really hear from us too often, only about important stuff. And then proceed to checkout. Once you will check out and receive confirmation email, what you can do, you can go into downloads. In the downloads you will see your plugin available somewhere over here, so I have it over here. You hit and download it. Once you've downloaded it, you can proceed into license keys. So license key will be listed somewhere over here. Then we go into plugins section of your website, which is typically located in a dashboard and plugins, and we will hit add new. Then you will simply choose upload plugin, go into downloads, find newly downloaded file, choose it, open, and hit install. After the installation, we'll go to the list of plugins, and there you will search for the installed plugin, which will be EasyPost Pro, and hit activate. Once it has been activated, we will navigate to WooCommerce Settings Shipping and EasyPost Shipping Pro tab. First of all, you have an ability to enable and disable it. So if it is disabled, no shipping methods will be offered and other features won't be available either. You will copy paste your license key here. You will copy paste your license key into this field. One of the options available here is that you can make it work for selected shipping zones or globally. So by default it is unchecked. It means that it will work for any kind of shipping zone. If you will check it and save settings, then you can navigate to shipping zones, choose a shipping zone and add a shipping method, which will be EasyPost Shipping Pro. Add shipping method like that. So as long as it is enabled, it will be offered only for this shipping zone and no other shipping zones will have EasyPost shipping methods available. For now, we will go back to the settings and I will uncheck shipping zone so it will be a bit easier to see for us. The second section of the settings is product key and test API key. They are required for a plugin to integrate with EasyPost service. You can get these keys very easily by following the link here. So you click on the link and API keys will be listed right away. All you do, just hit copy, go back and copy paste it. Same you will do for test API key. You can switch which key is going to be used by activating sandbox mod checkbox. What it allows you to do, you are able to purchase shipping labels for free in order to test your configuration. And once you go into production server, you will uncheck it and be able to purchase shipping labels that actually work. Cache expiration is a very important multi-purpose setting specified in seconds, and it is used to speed up your website as well as amount of fees owed to EasyPost for using their service. EasyPost typically allows you to have 3 shipping quotes for free for each shipping label you will purchase, and each additional quote will cost you 1 cent. So we suggest you to pick some reasonable number, for example, 7 days or whatever time limit which you think you will need to ship the package after first quote has been submitted. And the first quote is considered when customer got a shipping calculation in the checkout page, if you're using this feature there, or when you submitted this quote in the orders page when you were creating shipping label, which we will see later in this video. Integration settings set up, you can already proceed to the cart. In my case, I have a couple of products added, so I will simply refresh the page. And we can see shipping methods that were returned by EasyPost to us. In my case, it's Canada Post. We'll go back into settings. I will show you where it's set up. We have a from address here. So you can see my from address is set to be someplace in Canada. And this is why over here I am quoting to be shipped to someplace in Los Angeles, California. It's giving me shipping rates available by Canada Post. Let's quickly go back and see how debug mode works. So we'll enable it, save the settings, and we'll go back to the cart, refresh the page, and you can see over here we've got a lot of different messages, so it's fairly easy with a bit of attention to understand what's going on there, as well as you can always just copy paste like that this information and send it to us. So let's go over next section of settings, and the first option here is use seller address. So what it means is that we have the base address set up here, which is essentially our store. But if you are using some kind of multi-vendor plugin like Dokken and others, they work pretty much the same in this respect. You can use address of the seller in order to quote the shipping. Let's check it, save it. And if it first we had it set from Canada, our seller is actually located in United States, right? You can see here. So we'll go back to the cart and requote the shipping rate right now. And as you can see right now, we're getting USPS instead of Canada Post because it's already a local shipment versus what we had at the beginning. So our EasyPost plugin offers you possibility to quote these shipping rates based off vendor's address. So other available options here are possibility to include ship insurance with the shipping rate as well as signature service. By checking these checkboxes, shipping rate might be different from the original one depending on how particular carrier works. In the next section, shipping rate display settings, we are able to activate possibility to disable delivery time and tracking type in the quoted shipping rates. So we'll activate it and go back to the cart and we'll requote it. And now you can see that price is much higher than before is because we added signature service. And we can also see delivery estimate, in this case, 2 days, 2 days, 1 day. And here we don't see it simply because service isn't providing this kind of information. And the next feature we are going to look at is a media mail. Media mail is a special kind of mail offered by some of the carriers such as USPS, which allows you to ship certain products with much better shipping rates. For the restrictions, you have to check their website. So the way it works, we can either not offer it at all, or we can offer only medium mail shipping method, or offer it together with other shipping methods. So for example, let's check only medium mail shipping method, and then you can specify the condition which products have to match in order for it to be offered. Let's go for example with FlexRC tag and save the setting. Then we go to the cart and requote. And now you can see that the shipping method available is USPS media mail only. And it is much cheaper than previous ones. Let's go back to the settings and change it to be ship it together with other shipping methods. And record shipping rates again. And now, as you can see, we are getting media mail as the cheapest option, and then other options available as well. So depending on your needs, you can take advantage of this feature and save a lot on the shipping. All right, let's go back to the settings and review another feature of the product, which is possibility to adjust weight of the package. Some carriers like Canada Post, they require parcel to be at least 100 grams before it can be shipped. So this is what this setting is for. You can set 100 gram, any kind of weight you want really. Then in case you are shipping some kind of promotional materials or using same kind of packaging materials like bubbles, peanuts or anything like that, you can add this weight to the package, another 10 gram for example, as well as if you have a bit more complex way of how weight can be adjusted, you can multiply it by 1.2, which will mean effectively that 100 gram will become 120 gram and so on. In addition to that, there is another feature which allows you to adjust all shipping rates returned by the carrier. For example, you want to add some kind of handling fee for every package, or you want to implement currency conversion. You can do like multiply by 0.7, save the setting. So then in the cart, if we will requote the shipping rates, you can see that all the shipping rates returned by the carrier have been reduced. If we will add something like $3 for each shipping rate, so what we want to charge, for example, for handling our packages, and then we will requote shipping rates again, then you can see that we are getting much higher rates adjusted. So it adds you a lot of flexibility in order to get all your shipping rates to the point where you're comfortable with them. So another great feature of the plugin is possibility to define different parcels that you are typically using to ship your orders, and it allows you to get much more precise shipping rates. You will be able to define the name, which will be visible later in the order, then type of the packaging, length, width, height, then weight of the box, so it's going to be added to the total weight of the package, as well as inner padding in order to accommodate possible packaging material and get a better estimate of how much stuff can fit into each box, as well as maximal weight that it can handle. You can add unlimited number of boxes, as well as you can delete these boxes. Plugin will attempt to use as little boxes as possible in order to package the order, but then if it cannot fit everything into one box, it will select the best possible combination for that, and then it will attempt to quote each box separately and combine returned shipping rate to the customer. And in cases where you want to attempt to find a bigger box which is not defined here, you can choose combine all boxes, and what it will do, it will combine dimensions and weight of all the boxes necessary to ship the order and send only one request to EasyPost Shipping in order to get one shipping rate. Often it allows you to get much better shipping quote. You will also be able to configure services you would like to use. You will be able to change their name, modify shipping rate. So for example, what we will do, we will choose USPS first class, and then there is an option to enable or disable. So if it will be unchecked, then it will actually be excluded from the list. So let's save it. And then we go to the cart. As you can see in the cart, we have first class, and now we will requote it. As you can see, now it is gone. So let's go back, and now we will enable it. And instead of using USPS first class, we will, for example, call it my first class and deduct one from it. After saving, let's go back to the cart and requote it. So right now we see my first class instead of USPS first class, and shipping rate has been reduced on $1. You will also be able to uncheck this option, and this way we will only display services that are listed in this table. So let's save it. And now we are going to requote shipping rates. And as you can see, the only method that is left is my first class. So only methods that were listed in this table will be displayed when enable disable services option has been unchecked. Now let's look at how you can purchase shipping labels. EasyPost Shipping PRO plugin allows you to purchase shipping labels on per order basis as well as in bulk. So let's first review options available on per order basis. So in this case, we're looking at purchase postage flow. And what you can do is you can require to get a quote before shipping label can be created. What it means is that if customer, for example, chose to use first class shipping method, you will be able to get the quote and choose something else. It is particularly useful if you are offering free shipping and you are looking to get the best rate available. If it is unchecked, it will mean that it's going to use the shipping method that has been chosen by the customer during the checkout. Then you can require to create shipment before purchasing the shipping label. You can opt out or opt in to use this option. And then another option here is to require to confirm shipment details before you can purchase a postage. It also allows you to have extra reassurance that all details are correct. And depending on your workflow and how you have it all set up, you can uncheck all the options and effectively have one button shipping label creation workflow. So let's go to the order and keep all these options enabled for now and look at the workflow. In the order, we obviously have customer details, product, whatever fee, and then a method that has been chosen by the customer, which is USPS first class. You will also have a box EasyPost shipment where you are going to create your shipment. So first of all, we'll click add shipment. Once you click it, UI will add possibility to customize customs information. Obviously, if you are shipping within the same country, this information is less important, but you can still customize it. Let's go into options that are available for you in the shipping creation box. First of all, you can choose what kind of contents it has. So you can choose if it's merchandise, documents, gift, return goods, and others, as well as description. This description can actually be predefined over here. In case you are shipping same kind of products all over again, you can just define it once and it's going to be used over here. Third option here is parcel presets. The way it works is that when customer is placing an order and gets the first shipping crate quote, a plugin detects what kind of boxes that we pre-configured before are suitable for the order, and it's going to store this information. So in this case, you can see that it's offering box of these dimensions and marks it as detected. And all the dimensions are locked over here. Depending on the units you have set in your website, they're going to be different values, obviously, as well as weight that plugin has estimated. You can change this preset to something else depending on the situation. For example, you decided to go with this box, and it will automatically adjust dimensions of the box. And you can go even further and modify them yourself. For example, I want to use something like that, some square box, and it has the weight of 200 grams, for example. As well as you also will be able to specify the value, which is important when you want to purchase the insurance. So for example, it's 70, or I can do like 100 or whatever. It can be the value you want, so it's up to you. And obviously you can mark it to be as a medium L. In previous tests, we set it up to detect this product as a medium L, so it is automatically pre-checked. If it's not detected as medium L, it's not going to be pre-checked. And you can include insurance as well as request signature service, which usually increases shipping charges significantly. So once we have all this information here and confident with it, we can just hit get a quote. This is the first option that we looked in the configuration details, and it will have automatically pre-selected service that has been chosen by the customer. So it will will display the list of all possibilities with their relative prices, so you can choose what works the best for you. And for example, if you want to use priority, you can go ahead with it and create shipment. Now we can see this shipment confirmation dialog, which we were talking about before, that once again confirms shipping address, package details such as selected service, contents, package type, dimensions, weight and value. So I can just go ahead and hit confirm. After that, EasyPost shipment box is going to be updated with the shipment ID, which has been returned by EasyPost service, name of the service and the latest status. So options available here are refresh, which will be important in cases if you will just go into EasyPost and pay for this shipment. So then if you will hit refresh, it will pick up the current status of it. You can also delete the shipment before it has been paid in case you want to change it, as well as you can go ahead and purchase postage. So let's go ahead and purchase postage. Now, once postage is purchased, you are able to do the following things. First of all, there is a tracking ID available here, which you can click and see current state of it. Then you can also download shipping labels that have been created by EasyPost service. So as you can see, we have this shipping label, which is available in PDF as well as in PNG format. So then you can just go ahead and print them out. You can also hit the refresh button in order to be able to pick up latest information. As you can see, the sandbox of EasyPost allows you to kind of see the simulation of the tracking of the package, so it's all getting updated all the time. As well as if by some reason you decided that this shipment is no longer applicable to this order, you can go ahead and hit unlink. So what we can do, just to demonstrate it, I will copy the shipment ID and then I can hit unlink, which you can see effectively removed this information from the order. But then there is another option here. If by some reason you created shipping in another interface, like within EasyPost itself, you can hit link shipment and paste the ID and hit the link shipment, and it will automatically pick up all the information about this shipment. So for now, in order just to make it a bit cleaner, I will unlink this shipment again. We don't really need it here for now. Let's go back and see what will happen if we will uncheck to require get a quote option. So let's uncheck it, save, refresh order. Once again, let's hit add as well. You can customize everything and you can see that right away we have USPS first class service pre-selected. Parcel is still detected. Just go ahead and hit create shipment and it is still asking for confirmation. We'll go back and uncheck to require confirmation and save it. All right, so now let's refresh order again. And let's hit add shipment and create shipment. You can see now it's just immediately going to the service and creating the shipment. And we've got the shipment. So yet again, we can either refresh, delete shipment or purchase postage. So let's delete it for now. Go back to the settings and uncheck this option, which effectively should make it as one click purchase flow. Let's refresh order again. Hit add shipment. You can see that service, it's still pre-selected, all the same stuff as before. But instead, now we're getting purchase postage button, which we can just go ahead and click. And now we've got the shipping label just with one click. Again, you can go ahead and download shipping label. You can track this shipment and so on. So as you can see, EasyPost Shipping Pro plugin allows you to be very flexible in how you approach purchasing of the shipping labels. And depending on your preferred workflow, you can be either super efficient or super due diligent. So let's just recheck everything to make it work as before. And now we are going to look at bulk purchase postage workflow. So what bulk purchase settings allow you to do? First of all, you can enable or disable this feature altogether. You can allow to create shipping labels in bulk, even for orders that were not purchased with EasyPost shipping in mind. For example, you offer free shipping, you use some kind of table rates, and you still want to be able to use use EasyPost to create shipping labels for it, or you can uncheck it in case you want to skip these orders, as well as you can require to create shipment as a first step before you can purchase a shipping label. So let's keep all these options checked by default like that and go to orders. Let's look at orders UI here. First of all, you will notice that we have a new column here, which is shipment tracking. The order for which we already created shipment label for has the information here, which is tracking number as well as links to shipping labels. Orders without shipping label created yet have this tiny form, which allows you to adjust shipping information for them. For example, for this order, as you can see, we've detected it's going to be USPS first class and the parcel of this size, so you can see all this information matches. When for this order, which is going as free shipping at even value zero, that might be some kind of gift, nothing is displayed over here. So in this case, what you can do, you can click and select the method you want to use to ship and hit add. So you will see that order has been updated. And now we have this priority mail pre-selected and button has been changed to update. So scroll a bit to the bottom. For example, the difference between these two orders, that this order is still requiring our input through this form in order to be able to get a shipping label for it, because otherwise we simply don't know what to purchase. When for these two orders, we will be able to purchase shipping labels. So just like select like that, and then we see here two extra options: create shipments and purchase postage. The reason for these two options to be there is because we've got required to create shipment option activated. And for example, if we will uncheck it and save and go back to the orders and refresh it, when we will select orders like that, we will only have create shipments option, which will automatically purchase a shipping label. So let's go ahead and first review the default setting, which requires us to create and then purchase shipments. What we are going to do for the test, we are going to select these three orders, and the expected behavior is that for this order, which already has a shipping label created, it's not going to create extra shipment. And for these two, it will. So let's go ahead and choose create shipment and hit apply. And we've got two messages here. That first of all, for the order 32263, which is this one, shipment is already created, so it's skip it. And then requested rate has not been found, which is related to this order. As you can see, it didn't work. And the reason for it is that in the option which we reviewed before, which is related to from address, the from address is actually set to be Canada, and then we have use seller address enabled. So our seller is in the United States, but this order has been created without this option enabled. So the seller is still considered in Canada. So obviously it cannot find this shipping crate. So what we will do, we'll go and find Canada Post, Canada Post small packet US Air, and update it again. So now we can select this order once more and hit create shipments. Shipments have been successfully created. We have these two orders with shipments created, but without shipping label. So we will select like that and choose purchase postage. And here we go. We've got two orders with shipping labels created for them. As you can see, in the second order, we've got extra item, which is forms, which is essentially commercial invoice required for customs. If we open it, you can see there is an information here. It's coming from Canada to United States with information about product price and so on and so forth, as well as we can see here shipping labels for first and second packages. You can see the shipping label is different. One is USPS one and the other one is Canada Post. Let's now go ahead, reset these orders and try to purchase shipping label just in one click. So I'll just open them and unlink shipment for now. And I'm going to do it for every order. So before continuing, we are going back to the settings and uncheck required to create shipments and hit save. Now we will just refresh orders UI once again, select orders we're interested in, these three, and choose create shipments and hit apply. And as you can see, everything went smooth. And we have our shipping labels and tracking information present here in the column on the right side. The other setting which is left for us to review is support all orders, which was enabled by default. We're going to uncheck it. And the difference it will make that after refreshing it, we're no longer getting the form for orders where EasyPost has not been used for. So you can see we still have forms for these. These two were shipped with EasyPost as well. And you can see the latest status delivered. But other orders were not purchased with EasyPost plugin enabled for them. So there is no form here. And as well as we discussed before, you can choose your preferred behavior depending on your particular workflow. And now let's review the possibilities of tracking the shipment by you and the customer. So first of all, when we created shipping labels, customer is going to receive an email which looks like that. Note has been added to your order, which will typically contain tracking number after shipping label has been purchased, as well as track link. And if customer will click on this link, they're going to have their account opened, and it will contain information about their order, billing, shipping address, as well as tracking information. You can see here it got postage type, tracking, and so on. They can click on the tracking number and EasyPost UI will be opened at this point, as well as they can hit track. They can hit track, and once there will be more information, they are going to have the history over here. So let's look at how tracking information can be automatically updated by the plugin. For that, there is a setting auto tracking. In these settings, what you can do, you can enable auto tracking and specify things like how often you want auto tracking job to be run. For example, you want it to run every 10 seconds. How often you want each shipment to be updated, and this you have to pick some kind of reasonable value. For example, how fast it can move. Maybe you can update it once in 4 hours, once a day. It really depends. For the testing purpose, we are going to choose 10 seconds. And how many shipments do you want to update at once? It can be 1, it can be 10, it can be whatever number. So just depending on the volume of the shipments you have and the resources your server has, you can play with this number. Obviously, if your server is getting slower, you can reduce number of shipments and increase interval. If your server is fairly fast, you can have bigger numbers and smaller intervals. So say we want to update 100 shipments at once, and we're going to save this setting. You can limit for what statuses you want customer to be notified in case you don't want them to be spammed with every little detail of what is happening with their shipment. For example, you can choose send only when out of food delivery, or send it when shipment has been created. It's really up to you. And by default, if nothing is selected, it's going to notify for every change in the shipment, as auto tracking feature is getting this information into the system and it's changing from previous status to the new status. So after setting this information, we can go ahead and look back into account. As you remember, there was only a shipment created information over here, and I believe it should be already updated since the interval is fairly tiny. And you can see right now that it is already delivered, so we can hit track, and all the tracking information is going to display it over here. So what is good, EasyPost is simulating the path that parcel will take when you ship it, so it helps you to get a better understanding of what to expect, what kind of emails are going to be sent, and what is going to be displayed for the customer. As well as if we will go and check emails, we've got information like parcel has been delivered, which is the latest status of the shipment. Then if we'll go back to orders and refresh them, we will also see this latest status reflected over here, along still with the label and all the information, as well as if we are going into the order itself. And you can also see the history, which helps you to understand of where and when parcel has been located before it has been delivered. And if we will go back to the customer's account, they have orders interface over here. And it's going to have extra column over here with the tracking number where they can also click on it and see the tracking information at EasyPost, as well as obviously you can just go inside of each order and see the history as we've seen before for each and every order.
All right, congratulations that you were able to stick till the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed it and found it useful. Please, if you have any questions, suggestions, do not hesitate to ask them in the comment section below, as well as feel free to contact One Team Software and they will be more than happy to answer all your questions. Please consider subscribing to this channel. We are planning to upload a lot of useful content for you. And on that note, thanks a lot for watching and see you later.